Okay, I'm gonna go and videotape my dad.
Hey, come.
Yeah.
Stop, stop, up!
I would like to thank each and every one of you for walking out there today. Thank you. Thank you very much for doing that. And standing up for what you believe in. Racism and bullying are not acceptable if we are to walk together. The marginalization of one group or another is not acceptable if we are to walk together. When one race of people, through its citizens and institutions, tells another that they are inferior mainly because of the shade of their skin or the inferiority of their beliefs, it is not acceptable and we cannot walk together. Injustice, whatever shape or justification it receives, is not acceptable if we are to walk together. The wanton and wholesale destruction of this great land and denying the birthright of our bright children to clean water and the abundance that our Mother the Earth has to offer is not acceptable if we are to walk together. Racism will rear its ugly head when there is an economic interest. When a people can be made to believe that division, us versus them, is the only way that we can survive as a race. And we see that example every day. All we have to do is turn on the TV and listen to people like Trump that are propagating hate against one another. But I think we, the people here, can rise above that, and we know better. We know better that it is only through walking together that we can achieve what we really are intended to be here on Earth. Racism will rear its ugly head when its man-made institutions continues to attempt to subjugate and silence civilization. Think of Canada's Act for the Protection of Indians in Upper Canada in 1839. This later morphed into the Indian Act of 1876, that same year that Treaty 6 was negotiated. Think about that. The Indian Act continues even today and dictates the life of the hero from the time they are born to the time that they die, from cradle to grave. It defines who you're Canadians, recognized as an Aboriginal person, how they are to govern themselves, and the extent of their authority. It serves to depose the hero of their rightful possession of their lands and the resources. It's the creation of a legislation for one nation to level and extend to practice. Can I, for example, as an Indian person, legislate a white man's act? Can I, in that act, say how you're going to live, where you're going to live, who is going to be considered a white man? I will call this department the Department of White Man Affairs. Does it sound ridiculous?
Yes.
That is the reality of a sovereign NGO person today in 2018. This is what we have to live with each and every day. Racism will rear its ugly head when people are hurting and in pain. We will not show up in front of another the same person and pain that we feel. Sadly, this is a way to make ourselves try to feel better. To relieve ourselves of our suffering, it is misguided. But the reality is we experience it. Addictions, molesting of children, and violence against women and others need to be continued to be addressed. We need to treat each other in a way that speaks of respect and regard for one another. Racism will rear its ugly head when we teach hate and division to our children. It is something that is learned and taught to each generation. My friends, we are hearing a lot about truth and reconciliation in the past. There's a movement across the country to indigenize Euro-Canadian institutions. You can almost hear the cash registers ringing out the sales because money the scent is in the air of money. So what is truth? What is your truth? My truth is that my ancestors and up to today have lived on this great island we call the island of the turtle that we call North America. My truth is that Euro-Canadians and their ancestors came initially to trade with our people and then later sought the dispossession of their rights, their resources, and their land. My truth is that we're relegated and penned up like the bison that you see at Alberta National Park and made to live there on marginal land. I still have the memory of having grown all this land in whatever way that we, so that we could make a living. Today I am dispossessed. I cannot even go cut a tree down without having to obtain permission and having to pay a fee to the Euro-Canadian government. On my own land, even while the loggers and multinational companies continue to devastate the landscape all over the place and destroy the livelihood of my grandchildren. And it's not for their personal use as it was dictated in the treaty. It is so that they can sell it to buyers in distant lands. My truth is that infrastructure of St. Paul and all the other St. Pauls in this land. From the numbers that you see to that book that you use to build your home, to the public in your house, personal resources from this land that belong to the Aboriginal people. There is no compensation for that we have seen as yet. My truth is that I have a grand far greater chance than any other race in Canada of being put into a jail. Of being picked up by child welfare authorities. Just because of who I am. Reconciliation means that there's been an injustice and that we need to correct a right or a wrong. In our case, what that has meant for us is that Prime Minister Harper stands up in the House of Commons in Ottawa and offers an apology. Or Trudeau, what they say is, I'm sorry. Now let's carry on, just like we did before. No change has happened. We cannot talk about reconciliation without talking about justice, restitution, and compensation. The dialogue must continue. We need to remind those people repeatedly in a place of power that can affect change. Whether it's a multinational corporation or an ultra-right-wing conservative in NDP polling, or a Trudeau who has said your relationship is more important to me than that of the indigenous people of this country, that we need to dialogue as members before, based on equality and mutual respect. You can see that when you peel back the layers of racism that it touches on many areas, including history. But today is the beginning. Your presence here indicates that you desire to be viewed as a human being that deserves freedom based on respect and freedom from the fear of reprisal just because you are perceived as different or belong to that other group over there. I want you to conclude today by taking a moment to remember those men and women that were fighting and dying on those bloody battlefields in Europe 100 years ago. Especially my uncle, Joseph Quinn, my father's brother, who gave his life for his cause. He believed, as many of us do, that there is a time when we have to put ourselves in harm's way to defend our very existence so that our children may survive. So what did he give up his life for? What was his life worth? We can treat each other with respect. We can accept that people are different, not worse or better than us. Be they Muslim, Navajo, French, Ukrainian, gay, straight, a man, a woman, yellow, blue, red, white, even polka dot. We can change our thinking. We can change our attitude toward people. We can ensure justice is upheld for indigenous people. And finally, we will ensure our children are not raised to be fearful just because of who they are. Thank you.